I'm Robert Osborne. The second film in our Peggy Lee double feature is one that earned Peggy a Best Supporting Actress Academy Award nomination for the year 1955. Very significant honor considering that this was only Peggy's second time acting in a movie. This movie is called Pete Kelly's Blues. It's from Warner Brothers, and in addition to Peggy Lee's Oscar nomination, it's a movie with several surprises in it, including the man who made it. The film was directed by Jack Webb, who also stars as the Pete Kelly of the title. He's a jazz trumpeter who runs afoul of some gangsters during the Prohibition era of the Roaring Twenties. Now, up to this point, 1955, Jack Webb was basically known to audiences for his great TV series, Dragnet. On that weekly show, he was Detective Sergeant Joe Friday, who was always after just the facts, ma'am, just the facts. Webb produced, directed, and starred on that series, ma'am, producing it for his own company. 1 year earlier, 1954, Webb had teamed up with Warner Brothers to produce and direct a big screen version of Dragnet, and that had made a fortune. So with this next film, Warner Brothers gave Webb the freedom to do anything he wanted to do. And Webb, who was an enormous jazz fan, decided he wanted to do a film version of a short-lived radio show he produced for NBC in 1951 called Pete Kelly's Blues. Warners gave him an immediate okay to proceed. Now, much of the movie takes place in a Kansas City speakeasy back in 1927, where racketeer Edmund O'Brien tries to muscle in and take over the management of Pete Kelly's band. And all that leads to all kinds of rough stuff happening. Peggy Lee received her Oscar nomination for her performance as Edmund O'Brien's much-abused girlfriend. She also sings several songs, as does the great Ella Fitzgerald, who's also in the cast, along with the film's official leading lady, Janet Leigh, and with Lee Marvin and Jane Mansfield in smaller parts. So from 1955, here's Pete Kelly's Blues.